Last night, we told you about the new black holes in Sydney's rail network caused by the new timetable. Well, tonight we've got the pain that it's causing local businesses. Retailers claim the loss of commuters has slashed trade around Kogarah by about 40%. Here's Josh Murphy.
It was one of Sydney's busiest stations until 45% of the peak hour services were stripped away. That departure is creating gaps elsewhere.
My boyfriend works at the hospital as well, and so I have to catch 4 trains a day and barely see each other at the moment because basically on trains all the time.
Some are so angry they're bypassing it just like the trains.
And I used to catch a train from here all the time and it just doesn't sort of meet my needs anymore.
And since October 20, when the new timetable was introduced, it's meant a steep decline for retailers who claim it's killing Kogarah.
Dramatic drop-off. I mean, obviously it can't be slow because the trains aren't coming, so they're not here, that's it.
Some calculate an incredible 40% drop in trade, and businesses, traditionally a Liberal Party support base, are directing their anger at the Transport Minister, Gladys Berejiklian.
I don't know, Gladys. She's up at Willoughby. I don't think she's done her research.
Many fear the situation will only worsen in the new year when commuters return to work and potentially decide to change their travel patterns altogether.
To be noticed so quickly, it's just going to keep on going down, and we don't deserve it.
The government has said it's sticking with the new timetable no matter what, but opponents are maintaining the pressure.
The worst thing is shop owners in Kogarah are saying we weren't told about it. There was no consultation, it came in overnight, and it's devastating local businesses.
We'd like the trains reinstated. Basically, that's it. I mean, we need it.
Josh Murphy, 10 Eyewitness News.